situation. Canada, Ontario to be very specific, entered 4 weeks stay-at-home order. Schools has been canceled. And on top of that, it's gonna be raining for next 10 days. So instead of laying on a sofa, you know, and wasting my time, I came up with a project. In today's video, I'm gonna be shooting a B-roll or commercial sequence of a cosmetics product. Now, that's not everything. Today, I'm gonna be shooting with mirrorless camera, Sony a7S III. Tomorrow, I'm gonna be shooting with iPhone 12 Pro in native camera app. That will be video number two. Then I'm gonna be doing photography with Canon camera. I'm gonna take pictures of this product as well for a poster or ad. And on top of that, I'll take advantage of the setup and I'm gonna create another tutorial where I'm gonna explain how to shoot on Android in native camera app in pro video mode. You asked about that, video is definitely coming up. And that's not everything. I'll be submitting a lot of these shots to stock, so I might take you on a journey and actually show you how to do that if you want to make some passive income with your shots. So let's look at the products. Red nail polish, red lip pen, I think it's called. Red lipstick, another lipstick. Basically, it's gonna be red and sexy. It's not gonna be specifically commercial about one of these products. It's gonna be kind of like a fantasy cinematic B-roll. I tried to take off the labels, so I strip it down on some of them. I couldn't get it off, so I'm gonna work with it the best way I can. But now it's time for me to show you the equipment I'm using. By the way, I'm recording myself with Canon M6 Mark II, for those wondering, with a kit lens 15 to 45 millimeters. I'm just using a wireless microphone. Then here is the Sony a7S III with 17 to 28 millimeters and Tamron lens. And then the another lens is also Tamron, which is 28 to 75 millimeters. I wish I had macro lens and also another lens with much lower aperture. That would be wonderful, even though this is 2.8. Then I have a whole bunch of different lights here. I have also a product spinner. The main light is the Aperture 120D 2 with light dome. I'm gonna be using, for the first day, iFootage slider, because it's got many functions and I can position the cameras different ways. So that would be the equipment. I also went to the storage where I have my props, and I went through prop boxes and I tried to find anything which would help me in this project. Well, stores are limited now only to essential items. So you can buy food, you can buy medicine and all that, but you cannot really buy the props. So I had to really go through all the stuff I collected over the years. And here is all the stuff I came up with, which could possibly help me to create some of the shots. Do I have a plan? Sort of. I do have a little plan. I have like a few notes written, but no, not really, I don't have a plan. I'm not a planner. I like to go with the flow. I just like to prepare all my props, get the products, just get lost in a creative process and create some shots on the go. I'm gonna try not to repeat myself too much for day one and day two, which is filming with the mirrorless camera and filming with iPhone. This is not gonna be a scientific comparison of two different cameras at all. This is just fun project. And as always, whatever I'm gonna be using in today's video, all the equipment, the props and all that, I'll link in the video description below in case you wanna grab some of the items. The ones I bought in a dollar store, you might have to just head out to dollar store. Shot number one, which is the establisher. I have the products kind of grouped together, just standing on a table. I have main light here, lighting the objects. I placed a whiteboard to reflect the light back so it's not so dual looking, so I get reflection in the gold there. The camera is just sitting on a table and I put a lens cap under the lens to make it a little bit higher. Right now I have it at 17 millimeters, so it's 17 to 28 millimeters lens, and I have it at 17 millimeters. Right now my settings are, I'm filming at 60 frames per second because I might slow down some of the parts, and so it's 1/125th of a second shutter speed. Aperture 2.8. Right now only nail polish is sharp, everything is a little bit blurry. I might increase the aperture if I want everything nicely sharp, and ISO is 400 currently. All I'm gonna be doing really is moving the light back and forth. So it comes from a very dark, moody, to kind of nicely lit up scene. Another shot will be happening. I have a camera on a box to bring it higher so I actually clearly see the nail polish. I'm gonna take the product one by one and I'm gonna spin it. I have a spinner there. Now, I want the background totally black so I can take the object from the background and maybe multiply it a few times in a shot. So for that reason, I moved this light much forward so it's only catching the nail polish, but the background is black. And I'm gonna simply just spin it around and film it for a few seconds. Very simple shot. Another shot, I just want to bring a little bit more texture. So I grabbed the black feathers and I'm gonna be literally tossing them from the top. I had to cover the edge of the mirror because otherwise it would be very rough. So I'm just gonna go for it and start recording. So the next shot I am doing with a similar product, well, the other lipstick, but I'm gonna be using the feather and just kind of wipe in front of the lens to create a very soft effect. I might be using it as a transition, so I'm gonna also wipe the whole way to cover the lens. Mirrors, the girl's best friends or the worst enemy of mine and it comes to photography, but I'm gonna try to do some stuff just lifting the mirrors up. Maybe I can multiply it in a shot and use it something different, something unusual which I haven't seen needs to be done. Mix setup is ready. I overdid it a little bit, staged it quite a bit, added a lot of bling bling stuff there. So I'm using the slider and I changed the lens to 28 to 75 millimeters. Right now it's about 60 millimeters focal length. Aperture is 2.8 because I'm getting just some shots of those objects. I'm gonna let that slide from side to the side. It might be all falling, but I'm just gonna go for it. I'm gonna try. Yeah, it fell. After all, I decided to do some overhead shots, so for that I pulled out Mozza Slypod Pro slider. Well, I think I've done enough mess for today, so I'm gonna wrap it up. I'm gonna continue tomorrow filming with iPhone 12 Pro. And this is how it looks like once we edit it all together. Hit the thumbs up if you liked today's video and don't forget to subscribe for more because like I said, the next one with the smartphone is coming up. That should be a challenge. And if you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi, you know what to do. Leave it below and I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao. Ahoj.